Hello and welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to see something more about the audio. The other time we saw something about the waveform, we saw something about the spectrogram, we saw the high pass, the low pass, but there was something more I would like to tell you. So here we have Windows ready behind me and let's get started. Okay, here we are with Windows and the terminal. Here the folder that we're going to choose as our output folder. At the moment it is empty because what we would like to do is to perform some text to speech. So we're going to take some text, some input as a text, and then we're going to translate to put it as a sound. The version of FFmpeg that is available at the moment is the 5.1.2, something that we already used in the past, and it can be verified, the FFmpeg minus version, and here you can see that there is the 5.1.2. The library we are interested in to perform the text-to-speech is the libflite. So make sure that in the version of FFmpeg that you're using, so for example, if you compile it yourself, it is available there. So if you don't have it there, you can compile it. First compile the library and then enable it within the software. I made a video how to compile FFmpeg. You got to compile it and then enable the compilation, the compiling on FFmpeg. I will make another video for Windows in which we can include this library as well. Good, so let's get started. We're using it, FFmpeg, and as a format we've got to put LAVFI, something that we already used in the past. For example, it is useful to perform the to create test videos. And as a input, got to put the name of the library we're going to use. So in this case, it is flite equals to text equals to the thing they would like to take. They would like to make the software say. In this case, it should be between single quotes. And let's say that we want the software to make to say hello. This is Steph. Hello, this is Steph. We got to put the output file. The output file can be, let's say, hello tts.wav. This is a non-compressed output. And once we type enter, we have the hello tts. What we can do now is to play the audio, just to see if this can be playable. So let's play it.
Hello, this is Steph.
Good. So it is here available. Good. Cool so far. Now the thing that we would like to do is to take a text file and transform it into speech. So in this case, we have this text file. I will open it with a text editor, and the two sentences that we have here are: the quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. Now is the time for all good men to come to the aid of the party. So these are filler texts that I usually use. So I take the English ones. So there can be other filler texts, but at the moment, since we require some English sentences, this is what we're going to use. In this case, we can still use flite. The problem is we don't use the text as before. What we're going to use is something like another parameter. So still FFmpeg minus F LAVFI minus I, still double quotes, flite equals to text file equals to the path where we have this. So this is in my desktop folder. So I got to raise a level, sentence.txt. And again, this is text tts.wave. Let's name it like this in this folder. and then we can type enter, and let's see what happens. We have this text TTS, and we can play it. We can take ffplay, text TTS, and let's see what
the
happens.
The brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. Now is the time for all good men to come to the aid of the party.
Okay, good. And this is the other thing that we can do. So not only text is put directly there, but also text in a text file. I know the voice that is there available is not the best in the world. Maybe you don't like it. So if you would like to change your voice, you can. So there are some voices available. How can you reach those voices? You can take FFmpeg, minus LAVFI, minus I, flite equals to the flag list voices. You got to set to some value in order to see all the things. So this is the error message because it didn't do correctly, but here you have the list of voices. The default is Kal, K-A-L. If you like to use other voices, what you can do is use FFmpeg minus F LAVFI minus I still flite. Flite equals to text file. We want to use the same text file that we saw before. Yes, text file still up on one level, sentence.txt. And the other parameter, you got to put a colon to set the second parameter. The other parameter is the voice. So voice, in this case, let's say RMS. RMS, and as text output, we can put text TTS RMS dot wav. And we can type enter. We have a new file, and if we play, we have the text TTS RMS that we can play directly.
The quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. Now is the time for all good men to come to the aid of the party.
Okay, nice. Of course, playing an audio, so using a file may not be the most comfortable thing ever, but what you can do is to take, for example, FFplay, and you take all the options as before, flite in quotes, text file, the same output, text file we had before. And we can put the voice as let's say AWB, another voice from before. And if you play it like this,
the quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. Now is the time for all good men to come to the aid of the party.
As you just heard, you can play the audio in the other way. So if you have some advanced piping and you would like to take the multimedia stream from one side to the other, that's a thing that you can. You don't have necessarily to pass through a file. Still in the LAVFI family, what you can do is to, for example, generate a whistle, an audio signal with the sine wave of our choice. So to do that, we can still invoke FFmpeg minus F LAVFI. And in this case, the thing they would like to take in the minus I option is the sine. The sine we got to put as a parameter the frequency. In this case, we put a low frequency, for example, 100, 220, not to have to be so uncomfortable. I don't want to make you annoyed and neither deaf. So I think that we can do something like this. And we got to set the duration. How long we would like to have the video, we would like to have the audio to be played, let's say 3 seconds. And here we can put the output file. So here we have sine 220 hertz dot wav. And here we go. we play the video, convert the video, the audio into, generate the audio, and then we can play it. So, yes, sorry that I put the scenes and not sign, let me rename it, otherwise we get annoyed. And here, sign. Let's go. Okay, and here it is playable. Okay, so another thing that is useful under the LAVFI is the aevalsrc. So this evaluates an equation. We can put an equation and it will generate a sound given by the equation. So a thing that we can use is the FFmpeg minus F LAVFI minus I. In this case, we've got to put aevalsrc. Then we got to put the equation, so the sinusoid that is at, let's say, 140 hertz would be put at 440 times 2 times pi times t in this way. The second parameter that is necessary is the sample rate. In this case, it is 44,100 hertz. And we got to put the duration, so minus t with the duration, and the amount, the output file. In this case, it is a sine 140 hertz dot wave. Okay, we wait for the processing, and here it is. Then we can play it. So play sine 440. Okay, so I think that is being done. Okay, so far we dealt with other things dealing with audio. We saw the text-to-speech, we saw the sinusoid, how to generate that, and also how to say, how to put an arbitrary equation as an audio input, and this can be a good thing. So if you would like to make some test audio, so we did the thing for the test for the video, why not? We got to put the audio. So if you arrived up to this moment, thank you very much for watching, and remember, if you like this video, to like, share and subscribe, and hit the notification bell if you would like to get notified about the next video I will be creating. I hope to be more constant in the future. Stay tuned. I try to post a video every 3 days, but let's see, there is the possibility. Follow me on the social media, Instagram and TikTok. I try to be present also there with the time that I have. For the moment, thank you very much. See you next time with another video dealing with multimedia and much, much more. See you next time, and for the moment, ciao.